What does it mean to be at your ultimate? You strive not just to be good, but to be brilliant in your pursuits. You strive not just for growth, but for greatness. Forging your own path, surpassing your limits, and rising to the top. With passion, you defy. You conquer. You succeed.
This is how I live. This is me at my ultimate.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Stephanie Zubiri Crespi, and thank you for joining us here today at the special gathering of some of the country's most successful women here on Becoming Your Ultimate, Conversations with the Ultimate Women. We have lots to look forward to tonight as we get to know these lovely ladies, what makes them ultimate, and how they got to where they are, and of course, what's next for them in their respective careers. Make sure to stay tuned right here on Cream Silk's Facebook Live to catch all these and more. Don't forget to join the conversation. We want to hear your comments, so please comment in the comment section below. Also for a chance for some ultimate giveaways from these lovely ladies. So right now, it's the time to get to know them. Ladies, thanks so much for being here. How are you all doing?
I think it's a great dinner. All of us grilled together, bonding.
It's such a privilege to be seated in this table.
Amazing.
It's crazy.
I'm a little like daunted at the moment. with like my seatmates at the moment.
And it's incredible that we got, I mean, you ladies are all so busy that we managed to find time to have these nice, interesting conversations.
Anything for a cream soda.
Yeah. Okay, so, you know, what a lot of people want to know is what exactly were those breakthrough moments for you? I mean, everyone has a turning point. You know, we start from the bottom, we work our way up. When did you feel you were at your most ultimate? Jack, maybe?
For me, like, I felt like I'm at my most ultimate when I started getting, you know, attention, and then all of the people are like starting to support me that I thought I would never have. And then it really feels so nice for the people to support you, and even though you go through a lot of ups and downs, even though you get defeated, I mean, they still support you no matter what, and I feel like, oh.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's nice to have a community, right? It's nice to have a community. How about you, Rosenthal?
Well, I felt that I had reached my, well, for me, it's just one of the tiny baby steps of reaching my ultimate, but I really felt it when I had just finished my shows in New York. And, you know, coming back to Manila, I was getting so many inquiries, and, you know, it hasn't stopped since then. I really felt that this was, like, one of my most ultimate moments where I felt like I finally got validity as a designer, not just locally, but abroad as well.
Yeah, for a fashion designer, I mean, having a show in New York must be one of the ultimate goals, right?
Yes, I really died when I got invited to do it. And it's just been an uphill, not naman battle, but an uphill, you know, pursuit of wanting to constantly be better than the last thing, the last collection that you just brought out into the world.
Risa?
Well, me, from fashion to beauty, the makeup industry has been very challenging. When Happy Skin started around 5 years ago, it was a different beauty arena. It was 90% imported brands. So we wanted to be able to give women something that, makeup that cares for the skin and something that really suits the Filipina. So I guess, you know, the ultimate moment came when we got a collaboration with a global brand, Disney. And that was like an affirmation that, you know, that a global brand actually reached out to a homegrown brand, and it shows what the Filipina can do. And then personally, I felt at my most ultimate when SGV contacted me as a nominee for the Ernst & Young Women Entrepreneur of the Year.
Amazing.
That was something I didn't expect. Yeah, because, you know, more and more women are getting into business and starting their own, you know, brand or company, and it's not easy. So it's always a challenge. So to get that kind of affirmation that you're on the right track and to, you know, receive something like that is a big moment.
Yeah, that's amazing. Congratulations. Wow. Sambi,
Okay, from fashion to beauty to fitness. So I guess in terms of my most ultimate moment, you know, starting a startup and, you know, with any business, especially I think in the tech industry, it's a little bit daunting to have to reintroduce a more innovative way of doing things, especially with Guava Pass we're in. It's an app-based, you know, program, and there had a lot of educating, like a lot of educating had to go into it. So I think that my most ultimate moment was when I realized that the Filipinos were finally getting it. Like, it was crazy. It just happened like overnight. It was like a switch flipped, and everybody started to understand what we were trying to do, which was make fitness and wellness available and more available to the Filipinos.
Yeah.
And that in itself, I think, was the most gratifying moment in my career as, you know, Guava Pass
manager. Of course.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, tech is very male dominated. Yeah. Fitness is also very male dominated. So to be able to succeed in both those areas and helping a lot of people find their path through health and wellness. It's amazing. Miss Universe.
Yeah.
Why am I basking in your glory? Maybe just rub off
the
on me. Yes. So when was your ultimate moment?
I like what Rosenthal mentioned earlier, that it's hard to say, just like hard to mention just one moment, because what happens is you have a small moment that leads to another moment and then another, and then, you know, not to say that the smaller moments don't count, but they're all breakthroughs. So I had a lot, like, of course, a lot of people know that it took me, like, 3 times to join our national pageant first, Binibining Pilipinas, and even before that, like, not really making it into showbiz. Yeah. So a lot of little breakthroughs, and I feel like all of those rejections kind of helped me become stronger and helped me prepare for the next task, for the next step. And like also with Jack, I agree that it's nice to feel, it's nice when people start noticing your hard work. And then when people start telling you, acknowledging it also, like when your mentor starts seeing it, or your family or your friends or whoever matters to you, if they start seeing that you're getting better, like, I feel like that's a nice breakthrough, and it makes me feel like I really am at my ultimate. Yeah.
I think that's truly the most important, right? I mean, you could have all the accolades and success that you have, but if you don't have the validation from the people you love the most or from the people that matter the most, then it ultimately doesn't become as, you know, valuable as ultimate.
What about you, Stephanie?
Oh my God! Me tonight.
Good job.
Well, actually, just a small thing. My book, Feast With Me, which was published by Anvil Publishing, just won the National Book Awards this year.
Yay.
So that's huge for me. So passion project that kind of, was able to marry all my loves. And, of course, my friends and my family are in it, too. So, yeah. Hey, don't do that. You can take my seat, though. Okay, so this is a really interesting conversation, and we want to include you guys also in the conversation, and I want to read some viewer comments. Earlier, we asked some viewers what it meant to them to be their ultimate and what was their ultimate moment. Okay, so let's see. From Jessica Uy, okay? For me, being ultimate means being able to pursue my studies while doing something that I'm deeply passionate about at the same time. Super thankful ako that I can do well in my studies and continue my passion sa pagtulong and pagturo ng kids through student organizations or mga volunteer work. I can be both a student and a teacher, and that makes me ultimate. Oh, that's so nice. Yeah. Give back your time. Yeah. I guess balance is a big deal for all of us, right? Yeah. How do you balance your advocacies and your work and all of that and private life as well, right? Okay, fan answer number 2 from Sam De Guzman. Hi, Sam. As a working mom, usually here up mag-manage ng time because I have to juggle different roles. Pero I'm proud to say that I can take good care of my family and at the same time be a successful businesswoman. I have my online clothing shop that's been really successful for almost 5 years already. Wow. Now my first retail store. Bravo! Wow. It's in the works, and I'm a full-time wife and mom. The idea of doing my best, not just for myself, but also for my family, is what I believe makes me ultimate. Oh, wow, I can so relate, so relate. That's amazing. Thank you guys for your comments. Please keep commenting for a chance to win the ultimate giveaways, and don't forget to share the link on your page, okay? So we want more of you guys to join in the conversation. Okay, before we unveil our ultimate giveaways, we have, you know, it's... Everyone has, you've reached your goals, you've reached your ultimate, you're in a happy place, but how do you sustain your momentum and keep moving forward? What's in store for all of you?
You want to start?
Okay. Personally, for me, it's so hard to try to maintain, like, the energy from after winning Miss Universe, because, like, where do you go from there? It's like, I can't join another pageant anymore. It's like, my pageant days are over, guys. Yeah. But, so it's really...
You're still our queen, though.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice. But then, you know, I miss it, though. I miss it. I wish I could join again. But hindi na pwede. But, so I try to think of other things that I can do now, which is great, because before I couldn't, I didn't even have the time or the resources to, for example, go back to school. Like, yes. That's another thing that I'm thinking about. And... I mean, hearing all your stories, like, it's really so inspirational kasi parang gusto ko na rin magka-negosyo on my own. Alam mo yun? So, it's nice to have conversations like this because it, alam mo yung parang you get ideas and inspiration from, you know, your peers or your fellow ultimate women. And so for me, I'm still focusing on my advocacy and the things that I need to do kind of as a beauty queen. And also right now I'm trying out hosting.
Yes,
I have a travel show. I won't mention about it. I have a travel show in one of the channels there. also, I'm trying acting now. So I'm trying to kind of go back to what I was doing before Miss Universe, which was acting and modeling. And I'm just so excited about what's in store for next year. I don't wanna, cause some of them I can't reveal just yet, but they're all
very
exciting.
So we'll all stay tuned for all those announcements.
Thank you. It's just all very exciting. And actually bukod doon, excited ako for the things that I can do now because I feel like since I've achieved Miss Universe already, like I have the time now to, you know, take care of my family and then go traveling or like what I mentioned earlier, like go back to school. Correct. So these are the things that I couldn't enjoy before because of the circumstances, but then now I get to enjoy it. And it may sound so simple, but to me, like it's not... Parang you feel like...
Personal life is so important. Like, you know, the Japanese saying, ikigai, right? You have to have that balance between, like, your personal life, your professional life, your advocacy, so that you can be really fulfilled, right? Mm-hmm. It's hard to just give everything to just one aspect of your life.
And I think even if you feel that it's so simple, at the end of the day, sometimes it's the simple things
that really matter. They matter so much. And you see that when you have kids, actually. Parang,
family. Yeah, just, the people that matter the most to you.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Okay, what about Zambia?
Okay.
How do you keep that momentum? What's next for you?
Oh my gosh, what's next for me? I don't even know what's next for me. But I guess in terms of keeping momentum, to me, I kind of got addicted to the high that I feel when I've accomplished something that people say is impossible. So I do feel like a huge sense of fulfillment when I'm able to, you know, get past the challenge. And so I think as long as the universe presents challenges in front of me, I'm going to keep pushing through. So that's kind of how I've been keeping my momentum. I mean, with Guava Pass, for example, like for a startup, there's only really two endings to that. It's either you get acquired or you get big enough to IPO. And, you know, wherever the roads take me in that direction, I'm definitely still never going to stop pursuing and starting things that I think will make our country a better place. Yeah. And so, you know, if fitness and wellness is where my road is taking me right now, there are other passions I feel strongly about, like,
you know, like environment, for example, you know, trying to get rid of single-use plastics, maybe, lessening or coming up with different, more sustainable packaging and stuff like that. So that's definitely another thing that I feel very passionate about, and maybe that will be the next road.
That's great.
Yeah.
You know, we tend to forget that life is not short, it's long.
Yeah.
Life is long. I met a lady recently. She gave this talk, and she must have been in her 60s, and she just said she was one of the first women physicists, and she was actually offered like a scholarship abroad, and she didn't take it because she wanted to have a family. All the transformations that she came into politics, and she became a volunteer work and a philanthropist. So she's like, life is long.
Yeah.
You have so many life stages where you can still evolve. So it's not always moving up in your career, but moving
evolving also
elsewhere. Yeah. Rosenthal.
I think in terms of, you know, just keeping that momentum up, first of all, I want to say that all women should, you know, take the time to celebrate their little achievements. Yeah. I think a lot of women get so caught up in just so that one thing and, you know, not realizing how much they've improved themselves and, you know, maybe even the people they've surrounded themselves with. Personally, momentum-wise, I just always think, you know, what is the next great idea heading my way and what can I do to make sure that, you know, I'm open to the idea of it. The one thing as a designer that you can commit is to kind of close yourself off to new things. So as long as you keep yourselves open to the possibility of exploring new ideas, new concepts, you know, things that you may not have even considered or liked before. I think that just personally keeps me going as a woman, as a human, as a designer. And it's meeting women like you all that keeps my momentum going.
You get inspired,
and
right?
There are so many different stories that you hear from each one. Like, no one has a singular, you know, route
path
to success.
Yeah.
So it's just fantastic to see how everyone is able to achieve their goals.
But I think it's smart. Like, I love what you said about celebrating the small victories. Like, I actually made it to my yoga class today. That's a victory.
Especially if you have the time to work out. That's
a
big deal.
Oh, my gosh. Like, I mean, for all women out there, we shouldn't overpush it. Every day there's a small victory that needs to be celebrated, right? Risa?
For me, how do I keep the momentum? Well, the beauty industry is a bit... Well, it's so challenging today because more and more brands came in, but I'd like to think Happy Skin kind of paved the way for women to change their mindset.
Yeah. Thank you.
No, I mean, for women to change their mindset and to embrace also what's local and be proud of it. But it's good that there are more brands because that means more than ever we're all, you know, so engaged to make ourselves more beautiful and be at our best, whether it's through hair and cream silk and whether it's through makeup. So I guess keeping the momentum, you always look at problems or challenges, you reframe them as opportunities instead.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
And when you're always at a roadblock or you think something is so hard and you can't get past it, you always have to go back to your core or why you started it in the first place. I think remembering remembering your why is the most important. Why did you start this? And it will keep you back on track.
Mm-hmm. I remember one day I was so stressed out and I was talking to my friend who happened to be a life coach. She goes, "What's your purpose, ba?" I was like, "Bakit ba?" Like, "O nga no, bakit ba?" Like, we have to ask ourselves, right? What's the end goal and what's our purpose so that you always recenter yourself? Jack?
I just want to say, because I modeled for Happy Skin before.
Yes, and we did a shoot with you.
I really thought it was an international brand before, but it's so good. And I'm like, when I learned that it's Filipino, I'm like, whoa, it's so nice. Because I'm such a fan. But anyway, for me, I think the only way from here is up. Like, I choose to go beyond what's right here, right now. Because... after everything that happened to me, of course, it was a competition also, and then, you know, not reaching your goal or your achievement is kind of, like, very sad and depressing also. Yeah. But then I choose to believe in myself. And what's next for me is Well, a lot of things. Like, I don't want to mention them yet because I don't want to jinx it. The next for me is the world.
She's so cute.
Oh my gosh. So, no, like, I mean, I had a restaurant 5 years ago and I actually closed it. I failed. So a lot of people don't talk about their failures. And I think it's very important that, you know, it's a good next step to move on and then trust that God has something good for you planned.
And bigger.
And in its own timing. Yeah. So what you don't have now, something else might be waiting for you behind the door, right? Okay, so here's the next, I'm sure you guys are waiting for this. We want to know what our ultimate giveaways are. So maybe we can ask the ladies to share what we'll be giving away.
Well, I am giving away a GC from my most recent collaboration with Crema Dawn. So whoever will win will get a chance to purchase one of their own hashtag Crema Dawn by Rosenthal tea pieces.
Yay.
Out there.
Wow. She's got really great stuff, guys. Like, I love her little crop tops.
Thank you.
Nice details. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to be giving away a yoga mat. So, you know, in the fitness industry, obviously. But, yeah, so yoga for me has kind of also been kind of my zen moment. And so, you know, I'm sure there are a lot of Filipinas out there that are very stressed, very hard on themselves, and sometimes you just need that time to reflect and go back and just meditate a bit. And I thought that maybe a yoga mat would be helpful to someone out there.
Definitely. Yeah. And you, I mean, of course, you could also take the classes through Guava Pass. The great part about yoga is it's anytime, anywhere.
Stop, drop
yoga, right? Okay,
I'm giving away, I actually have it here because I'm wearing it. It's our best-selling lippy. It's the Honeymoon Glow Shade. And I'm also giving away a lippy from our holiday collection because, you know, sometimes a swipe of color can really change how you feel.
Definitely.
The start of your day, and it can empower. So I want to share that to whoever wins this. I mean, a lippy can really change your day.
Definitely. It gives you so much energy, right? Like, if you're tired, bright color.
One swipe.
All right, guys. So mine is, I actually can show you guys. It's right here.
Ooh, wow.
Prepared ako, guys. So it's a makeup kit, but right now, may kasama siyang cream silk. So
that's so nice.
So, and then...
Oh my gosh.
Wow!
Diba? So, may cream silk na dyan for you guys. And kasi I also have one of these of my own. Cream silk gave me, and it's really useful. I love the lights inside, and I just think that
women... that makes all the difference.
Yes, of course. Like, especially when you're on the go, and I feel like a lot of women right now are so career-driven, and we're always so busy, so on the go, pwede ka nang gumanda.
Oh, yeah, that's right. In the car, right?
In the car
with, like, the flashlight.
Yeah. Hopefully not while you're driving.
No. No. Jack?
For me...
Just kidding.
For me, I'm giving away a GC from Una Rosa because they're the first brand that approached me after the show, and I really am so grateful for them because it's my bounce back after everything. And, you know, I just want to share it to everyone.
Great.
That wins.
Oh, it's so exciting. How come I can't join? So great. Thank you so much, guys. I mean, I know that all the modern Filipinos out there would just love to get their hands on these beautiful prizes to help them also empower themselves in their everyday lives. I like that. Okay, so if you want to be one of the 5 winners of these beautiful items, please don't forget to comment below. I want to hear your insights, your questions, and don't forget to share this on your feed so more people can join the conversation and help spread the word to empower Filipinas all over the country. Okay, let's continue the discussion. I actually want to read some of the questions from the viewers this evening. This is always fun. Okay, so our first fan question is from Ellie Castro, and this is, I think, for Risa and Sambi, okay? Let's read this question. Yes. Okay, I know all of you have a lot on your plates. Tell us, what is a typical day like for women as successful as yourselves, and how do you manage your time? Woo! Can we have, like,
timer starts now.
It's hard.
Well,
okay.
I guess for me, I take on so many roles. I'm not just an owner of a business, or I'm not just running a business. I'm also a mom to 3 kids. Yeah. I'm also a beauty columnist, and I'm also taking up my MBA right now.
How do you look so fresh? She looks so fresh. Oh my gosh.
No, I mean, Yet. No, I don't. I sleep at 3. I know it's bad, but I think it's something I just got used to. But so my day is really full from looking after the household and the kids and running a business and sustaining a column. You also write, right?
Oh my gosh. I'm so delinquent now.
So to taking up my MBA. So after a full day of work, I also have class at night. And it's a bit of sacrifice because sometimes I don't get to see my husband or kids.
Yeah.
And then morning ko na lang sila makita. But sometimes you have to make, you know, it's a decision my husband and I made together because I know he would also be making sacrifices.
Correct.
So I guess when it comes to managing your time, we're always juggling so many things. And if everything is number one on the list, you're really going to go bonkers. So you have to know how to prioritize which is number one, number two, number three. And, you know, it will make more sense to you instead of trying to make everything number one. I mean, I think family will always go first.
But every day it changes, right? So like even for me, my priorities in the day will change. Like
definitely.
Today it's all work, tomorrow it's all family. I just drop the work because that happens to be the most important at that time. What about you, Sambi?
Okay, well, I'm not a mother yet, but I'm a dog mother. But I guess the way that I start my day is I wake up very early every day. So I'm usually up by 5 a.m. every day, kind of automatic at this point. And that kind of allows me to get in the right frame of mind. So I start my day with lighting an incense and kind of meditating to get my thoughts in order. I'm also a big believer of checklists.
Okay.
So I love starting my day with like a long list of stuff to do on my checklist. And I feel super fulfilled every time I check one off.
Gosh.
It's the best feeling ever. So I start with that. And I usually start answering all my emails by like 7 a.m. and I usually get all of those done by 10 a.m. After that, I'm kind of meeting after meeting and I have a lot of conference calls because I deal with a lot of execs abroad as well. So sometimes the time difference is also something that I have to deal with. And in between, I'll try to squeeze in a workout, which is kind of fun still because that's kind of how I release the stress and the anxiety or whatever pressures I have. But I do agree with you. Well, you know, it's all about prioritizing, and I think time management definitely goes a long way, and it's definitely a work in progress. I think we all kind of go through the phase where you kind of learn not to procrastinate.
Yes.
And so I take that time in the morning to kind of do all the things I don't want to do first and then let everything kind of simmer down. Yeah.
Although they do say that your brain is fresher in the morning and they say that to be more efficient, you get all the writing and nitty gritty work out in the morning and then everything else should be face to face contact.
Yeah.
Supposedly. I don't really follow it.
It's worked for me.
I mean,
so
I guess everyone's
our own thing, right? Okay, our second question is coming from Francesca C. Hi, Francesca. This question is for Rosenthal and Jack this time, okay? Hi, guys. What keeps you motivated to reach for your goals in life? Okay, so in your career as a model, Jack, and then maybe your career as a fashion designer. Okay, Jack?
Well, for me, I don't want to settle. Like, I don't like settling. That's why I try to keep everything ongoing and I try to get everything because you can't miss a chance. Like, this is the only opportunity we have. Like, you live a day by day.
Yeah.
So you get everything done today and then tomorrow. And then what keeps me going is also my family. I really want to help them. And this is my way of giving back also. And this is also for me to achieve my goals and to go beyond my limits.
Well, I think anyone who is crazy enough to enter the industry that is fashion on the get-go is the type of person that can never sit back on their laurels and just, you know, be fine with things. Like, as Jack had just said, she's not the type to settle, and definitely that's the same for me as well. You know, every time I produce a collection, it's always like burying my soul with whatever creative thing that I'm, you know, concocted up. And, you know, each and every time you're always, well, I'm always very anxious with how people will react to it. But at the same time, it's also kind of exhilarating. Yeah. So people have told me that I actually ask, like, I say that I'm stressed out all the time, but people always tell me, well, my friends always tell me that I also kind of just ask for it because if without the work, I get so anxious and, you know, just like not doing anything. it really ticks me off. So I think, you know, people like us in the fashion industry just need to be constantly on the go. And I think that keeps me motivated as a designer. Like, what is the next, you know, idea, the concept? What can I do better as a designer for my clients and for my international, my international clients as well, and the local? And how can I just empower women through my clothing? Because in my, well, my clothing is always, well, I try to, my mantra as a brand is to be strongly feminine. And so I want anyone who's in a Rosenthal tea piece to really feel, you know, the strength as well as the beauty in whatever it is that they've gotten from me.
Oh, that's nice. Like, yes.
Padena ba?
Yeah, and it's like, very cutthroat, right? Fashion is so.
That is such a hard industry.
I know. Actually, one of my favorite photos from a shoot, I was wearing your top. Like, super beautiful. Okay, our third question is coming from Grace Villamor for Pia. Okay, how do you deal with different kinds of pressure, like stress or people doubting you?
Wow, like I get
that's a loaded question.
All the time, guys. Like it's constantly there. And okay, before when I was still competing, when I was still a candidate, like and that. Whoops, sorry. Nap queen. It says nap queen on her.
It's my case. So cute.
Okay. When I was still, I felt like I was still competing, and then I wasn't getting it. I get pressure from myself. Like I tell myself na, my gosh, Pia, nakakahiya talaga kung matatalo ka na naman. Alam mo yun? Like I talk to myself, and then whenever I have people like doubting me or stressing me out, like I feel like I just have a way, and I think this works naman. I just have a way of using that as my fuel to go even more. Yung pang when I hear them say na, oh, hindi mo kayan, or you can't do it, or you're gonna lose again, or no way this is gonna happen to you. Like I listen to that, and then I go to the gym. You know, like they tell me that I can't do it, and then I train even more, and then I study harder, and then I. You know, I train more, and then you just use that, diba? You gagamitin mo yon parang kailangan all the negativity. You have to be able to use that as not anger but as
fuel.
Motivation.
Fuel.
Yes, fuel to keep going. So that's what I try to do. And even now, the pressure is still there because that's always the question. Like, oh, like what's next? Like, what are you gonna do next? And there's always the pressure of. Kailan ka ba mag-Hollywood? Yung palaging ganun yung naririnig ko. And, you know, hindi ako lumalaban, but then in my head, like, I'm hearing it, I'm listening to it, and then I'm just doing my own kind of preparation as I've done before. So that's what I do, and I think that's what some women can also try doing. Try nyo yung way ko. Try nyo, baka mag-work sa inyo. So, yeah. That's how I do it.
It's so true. We're our toughest critics, right? Yeah. Like, we have to learn to be kind to ourselves, and actually that pressure is not necessarily coming from everywhere else. It's, you know, trolls are going to troll and haters are going to hate. So you just
and
let
what
them
they're thinking of in your head might be like 10 times even worse.
Completely.
Wow. I also transform it into something positive, because if you get the negative, if you let the negativity in, it's just going to affect everything
around you.
Like, I also really love, just really love what you said earlier about like not, parang huwag mo kalimutan yung mga little achievements mo.
Yeah,
and then,
for sure.
I think that's what usually happens when you always compare yourself to others. People or to other women. And then coming from galing kami pareho sa competition na ano na, diba? Like,
It's a battle between women.
You and other girls. Yeah. And like, it's important that you don't apply that outside of the competition. Like, don't apply that to your life. Like, it's not always like that.
It's not always about the world.
Yeah. And especially with social media around.
Oh, it can be so toxic, right? It can be really toxic.
Like, you see this girl, like, and you're thinking to yourself, like, oh no, like, I know I did well, but somehow it's not good enough. Kasi hindi ganito or hindi ganyan. And then you, like, with social media around, you just tend to, and it's normal. It's normal, but then it happens. That you will you know, doubt yourself or compare yourself. But then what's important is you just focus on yourself and think na, kunyari sa akin, like, Pia, how was Pia like a year ago or 5 months ago or a week ago? Yeah. And as long as I know that I've done the right steps in becoming better, that should be enough. And I think that's something that, you know, I love what you said earlier. Ayoko lang mahalimutan, so inano ko lang.
That actually reminds me of a super awesome quote that I saw recently. If you are captivated by purpose, you won't be distracted by comparison.
Yeah.
Right?
I love that.
Right? Because if you're completely captivated by what you're doing and what you're trying to do with your life, then you don't really care to compare yourself with other people. And the truth of the matter is, there is space for everyone
on
the top.
There is.
Like,
there
if Cream Silk can find 100 ultimate women, that's nothing. I think Cream Silk can find 1 million ultimate women, right? Yeah. So there's space for everybody.
I mean, I also don't like to think of top or going up.
Yeah.
I believe in moving forward.
Yes.
Right? We just keep moving forward. That's the trajectory. It's not necessarily climbing hills, because mentally you're like going, it's a climb up. Like, no, it's like I'm just moving forward one step at a time. Sometimes I'm running, sometimes I'm slow, but it's just as long as you keep moving forward and evolving, right? Thank you so much for answering all our fan questions. I'm sure you guys were really happy to hear all their insights, and everything got very personal here, so that's really nice.
Okay, feelings involved.
Yes. Okay, guys, you still have a chance to be one of our lucky winners of our guest's ultimate favorite. So make sure to keep those comments coming, okay? All right. We are almost at the end of our Facebook Live. Okay. Oh, so sad, but now we get to eat. Sorry, we're all, I know you guys are probably eating your dinner while watching us, but we're like growling here, okay? But to wrap it up, I just wanted to ask you guys what your, you ladies, what your tips or mantras are to continually strive for your ultimate. What are the words you live by or tips that you can share with the audience? Who wants to start? You want to answer first?
Something that I live by. There's a few. I mean, we all have a few, diba? We all have a few that we like to remember every now and then. But some. Medyo hard. Ito, sa akin na galing to. I'm not gonna try to. Sa akin na, like, something that I learned is that if you want something done in a certain way or a specific way, like for yourself, for example, like you have a goal, like you have to do it yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, sorry. Pero ganun talaga. And I also think that, I mean, nagbabago na rin naman ng mga panahon ngayon is women are more career-driven and like we like to go out and, you know, like go out and go for our careers and our dreams and our goals, and I think that's great. And for anyone who's watching right now, yung sarili mo lang, and I'm dito hugot or anything, ah, like guys, ah, sarili mo lang, yung ikaw lang yan. Like when you're on stage, ikaw lang yan. When you're taking that test, ikaw lang yan. Kung may nililigawan kang yung babae na yan, ako, ikaw lang yan. Diba? Like whatever it is that you want to achieve, it's on you whether you want it badly enough or not. Yeah. Ay, grabe.
Wow.
Grabe. So, yun yung advice ko.
She's just like, edit there. Mic drop. Okay.
I know, that's it.
Jack?
I'm still thinking. I'm not like Miss Universe, you know. Okay. My mantra, for me is, it's kind of like similar to her, because I always think to myself that you are in control of your own life. Mm-hmm. And parang, because I always get like hate comments also, and I always get like negative stuff said to me, and then it's ikaw lang naman makaka ano nan, like you should not let it affect you. Mm-hmm. And kasi in the fashion industry, like sobrang daming ganun na parang okay meron silang ideal ganito ganyan, okay you're hindi ikaw yung
face. Yung face.
Yeah. Hindi ikaw yung peg namin.
And when you're so public, parang they feel like they have the right to their opinion, right? Yeah.
And then parang, I always get na parang, lagi akong, like, na-judge as a person in my day-to-day basis. So, I just, parang, ano, pasok sa isang ear, labas sa isang ear. because yung mas important is you know for yourself na you are beautiful and you can do greater things than this. Like, marami pa yan. It's not just this small. It's that aww, big.
It's yeah. Really nice. Big.
Yeah. So kung may opportunity na hindi para sa'yo, may mas malaki pa yun.
Of course, for sure.
Not just for fashion industry, but for everything.
Everyone.
Yeah. Okay, well, since we're in the fashion, I'll answer next. My personal mantra is that I guess the most important voice you need to listen to at the end of the day is your own. I produce things on a daily basis that gets judged by so many people. And in being in a field that kind of makes you vulnerable to that, you kind of need to toughen up or thicken up your skin. Is that the right term? Like, toughen up and, you know, realize internally that yours is the opinion that matters above everyone else's. Yeah. You know, some people may love or hate the last thing that you did, but there's always the next one to do. Like, and as you were saying, Steph, it's just about moving forward one step at a time. It's not like I'm gonna climb Mount Everest of blah, blah, blah goals. It's just taking it on a daily basis and learning from it. Mm. So, yeah.
Sandy?
Well, I guess for me, it's just, you know, it's very similar to what Pia said, where you know, the best way to tell your future is to create it. And I think that at the end of the day, like, you just have to know and depend on yourself. Like, if there's anybody in the whole world that I can trust, it's me. Because I can trust myself to bring me places. And I think that that really goes a really long way to be able to have that sense of self-belief. And I think that, you know, when I was a lot younger, and I'm sure a lot of younger women can relate to this, wherein, you know, there's so much self-doubt. And you always second guess yourself. You always listen to the opinions of other people, and you always kind of take a lot of things to heart. And it's hard to internalize and actually believe in your own capacity. But I do think that it goes a long way. So, you know, more than even move forward with anything, try to internalize. And maybe that's the best advice I can give everyone, because I try to do this on a regular basis. And that's what kind of helps me get past all of the negative comments, which is, you know, to just internalize and list down the things that you know you're good at. Like, list down the things that you love about yourself. And, you know, once you have that self-love, then it'll just grow outwards and shine outwards. Yes. So, yeah, that's how I live my life. That's my mantra.
Well, I'm the last pressure. I hope I can give a Miss Universe answer. No, but, you know, listening to all of you, I think all women, even the ones watching right now, go through a personal struggle, whether it's being teased or being judged or being, you know, criticized because of the industry. And you always have to go back to yourself. And whatever it is that you're going through, I think the most important is transcending that difficult thing. I think it's going beyond. You shouldn't let it be a roadblock. It should make you better, whatever, no matter how hard, how painful, or how difficult it is. Sometimes you want to forget about it, but yun yung nagpa ano sa'yo eh, diba? Nagpa that fuel that made you stronger, bigger, better. And I remember this quote that what I once read, the same fire that melts butter is the same fire that purifies gold. So I think that should, you know, remind us that no matter what we go through, we're always going to turn out better, even if it's painful, like fire or burning. But fire, you know, those fire can be good and bad, and we just have to come out like gold.
Yes, that's wonderful. Well, I mean, wow, all these wonderful answers. I think also I would like to take the time to say, let's live our lives in gratitude as well. Yeah. Because sometimes when we hit a wall, we think of all the things that we didn't get, but we actually have gotten so much, right? And that's a really big, big thrust forward in terms of fuel for life, just to be grateful for everything you have. And I believe all that comes back. So thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
My gratitude for all of you to spend time here and share all your insights. But before we end, can we announce the winners of our giveaways?
Oh, yeah.
So thank you for joining. Okay, Risa?
Well, the winner of the Happy Skin lipsticks is only one winner, Nala Jacobs. Congratulations.
Okay, so for me, who won the yoga mat, congratulations, Marian Kolongon.
The winner, well, the winner of the Kermadon by Rosenthal TGC is Mayan Mabesa Mejares.
And the winner for Una Rosa GC is Alma Dajau Gwingwing.
Okay,
and did I say that right?
I'm not sure. And the winner of the vanity ticket that I'm giving away is Janice Yeno Sapamul.
Yay, congratulations, ladies.
Congratulations.
Wow. Amazing. Thank you so, so much. Can I just express my gratitude again? This is so special. You know, and thank you guys for joining us here tonight. I hope you learned so much. There's so many things, like wonderful insights. Things got really hits. Okay. And whatever your takeaway was from this evening, I hope you can use it to better yourself in your career, your personal life, whatever industry or passion you might have. Once again, I'm Stephanie Zabiri Crespi, and this has been Becoming Your Ultimate, Ultimate Conversations with Ultimate Women.
What does it mean to be at your ultimate? You strive not just to be good, but to be brilliant in your pursuits. You strive not just for growth, but for greatness. Forging your own path, surpassing your limits, and rising to the top. With passion, you defy. You conquer. You succeed. This is how I live. This is me at my ultimate.